Welcome back. So, today, I have a jar that I use for my runes. It's a little ceramic jar. And I have been, over the past few days, planning, drawing, and making bind runes to put on it so I can paint them. Well, I've drained myself making these bind runes, and they're all fortune, good fortune, good luck, and protection bind runes. So I've drawn them on, and now I am going to paint them on. So that's what we're going to do today. Now, I'm just going to paint them black. I'm not going to do anything wild, just painting them black. Maybe later I'll do something else, but today we're just going to paint them black. So I'm going to get the camera set up, angled down on it, and we'll get to painting. Okay, so I've got the jar ready. It's just one of these latch jars. I found this for like 50 cents at our local thrift store. So this is the one that's going to be on top. This one, you can see that. You'll see it better after it's painted. But, and then there's this one. So we're going to paint. Okay. I've got my paint over here and my water to dip it in, and so if I don't screw it up, it's going to be easier said than done, I think, but hey. Because I do not have the steadiest hand. But I don't think it has to be perfect. That's the point of the bind runes, is those little imperfections. That's what makes them ours, right? That, my hands have been shaking for the past few days. So, that's too much. That is far too much. Well, at least it comes off pretty easy, right? Ish. That's the plus side of it being ceramic, or it's either ceramic or porcelain. I'm not sure. But I know it's enough to be, you know, nice. Anyway. But it's like, you know, I see people, there are perfectionists out there that think that all bind runes need to be symmetrical and everything else, that they need to be perfect. Well, they don't. You really think our ancestors, when they made... Now, I know bind runes are post-Viking era. And that's okay, you know. But we adapt and we make our own as we need them. That's important. But it's like, so there are people out there that seem to think that bind runes need to be perfect, perfectly symmetrical, perfectly designed. I don't necessarily believe that. I think they just need to be yours, right? To me, that seems better to be yours and yours alone, to be unique to you, your own little imperfections to them and everything. That's what makes them important. That's what makes them unique to you, is the little imperfections. I don't have a steady hand. I'm not the best at painting, clearly. But I try, right? I try. I know this is just riveting, but I don't have any names for these Bindrunes yet. But that's okay. I don't need to name them right now. I just need to paint them on. Because at the end of the day, what matters is that they are together and ready. There you go. There's one. I like that one. That one makes me really happy. I'm sure you can tell which what is what on it. You've got Perthro and Sawillo and Lagus. And of course, Issa. Like I said in my previous Bindroom video, Issa is in every single Bindroom. So, I'm just trying to do this so I'm not sticking my hand on one that's already painted. But let's go ahead and do the one on top. I'm sure there are easier ways to do this, and I'm being extraordinarily difficult about it, but like I said, I'm not a painter. Personally, I don't like painting. Personally, I do not like painting, but it's not that big of a deal. I know a lot of people who love to paint. I mean, adore painting. And good for them. You know, everybody needs a hobby, right? My hobby is woodworking, making Bindrunes, reading the runes. All of that fun stuff. Ooh, that's way too much on there. There we go. Okay. Let's see if I can figure this out here. Yeah, give me a wooden power tool and I'm set. Or a wood tool, whatever. Give me a paintbrush and it's like, ugh. I'm just not good at painting. But I wanted this object to have some, you know, some magic to it. Where it holds my runes. You know, it's got the power of the runes in it. But I wanted something that spoke, that told us what it was. And this makes it unique and makes it specific to the runes, right? What's that over here? Is that pretty close to being dry? This one I'm proud of. This one I really am proud of. This one turned out well. It's Gibo and Issa, of course, and Kinas. So. And Ingwaz, actually. So, I gotta figure out how to hold this thing. Here, we'll do it this way. Here we go.
I'm hoping you're able to see that. I can't see the angle my camera's at right now. So. But I don't know. I'm not talking a whole lot, but I struggle with multitasking. So now we're getting somewhere.
See, now we're getting somewhere. Yeah.
Okay. We're getting there. We're almost there. We're almost there. This will be the last Bindrune on it for now. I'll probably add more to it later on, but right now this is where it's going. Now, the main reason why I'm doing this is because on my altar upstairs, this thing's kind of an eyesore. Because it's surrounded by an idol. Well, two idols, Tyr and Thor, right? And it's surrounded by, it sits on a plate of Jormungandr. Surrounded by candles and incense and basically Bindrune sigils and all kinds of stuff. But it was bare. It was plain and it needed more. It needed something to stand out on its own. So that's just kind of what I'm doing here. Is doing it. Making it its own. So, just trying to bring it all together, make it its own thing by dolling it up a little bit. Because that's one of the things we take pride in, is the way our altars look, the way we dress them up, you know. The way we make them our own. Because appearance is important in our faith. You know, making our own style based on the culture. I mean, I'm a redneck. I'm a redneck, just how it is. And There we go.
See? That one I'm proud of. That one's pretty cool. I like that one. But it looks better now. It looks different. But we, you know, I'm a redneck. I have a tendency to just dress up as I'm comfortable. T-shirt, a flannel, my big wide-brimmed hat, boots, torn-up jeans. Just kind of how it works. But we all sort of pride ourselves on enjoying and using our culture, the culture we come from. So that's another message for this video, is we take what we have and we make it specific to our faith and specific to us. So, but I just want to do that. I know it's not riveting, but hey, hit that notification bell. Like, subscribe, and share these videos. Throw a comment down. I don't care what you talk about. Talk about something. Yeah. And I will see you in the next one.